Oh my god, that thing is hot. I'm just saying, you know, it's got fire. I meant it like that. Hey, what's up, guys? It's Pat, and welcome back to another mod showcase. And today we're checking out the Arcana RPG mod. And actually, I'm really excited for this one, guys. It is brand new. It adds in two dimensions, bosses, weapons, tools, armor, all kinds of crazy stuff. There's something for everyone. No matter what you like in Minecraft, you're gonna find something. Like building? Build with this weird block that looks like it has some kind of disease. There's all kinds of stuff. Got building blocks over there, building blocks, new lamps, and even ore, guys. Look at this one. This is actually like a creepy looking ore. It's freaking beautiful. I love it. I love every single one. So yeah, guys, if you're excited for this one, take a second to, throw your meat onto that like button. We'll go with that. Just, you know, grab it, eating some meat right now. Just smack it right on there. Show your support and let's do this. Alright guys, so first up, we're gonna check out the ores in front of us. There's a ton of mining to be done. If you love mining, you're really gonna enjoy it. If you don't, ignore it. You don't have to get this stuff. So right here, we got some purple obsidian. It looks like it's got like fractals or something. We've got normal ore, some cool looking ones, and there's even more ore to mine in the nether, which is epic for when you're traveling around. And guys, there's a lot of decoration blocks. Look at this. We have brand new lamps to light up your world, cool nether particles coming off these. These are actually probably my favorite. I think that would be so sick in a build. Over here, we have more blocks as well, as you guys saw before. But the main thing about this mod is the adventure aspect. There is tons of weapons, armor, tools, and some stuff I've actually never seen before in a mod. So check this out with the weapons. So one thing you're going to notice is there's a lot, like tons. And guys, once again, if you don't know the recipes, use not enough items. It'll save your life. You'll live longer. You'll be happier. You'll just be a better person. You'll be a worse person without it because you'll never remember all these anyways. So I'm not going to go over them. But right here, guys, you're going to notice this. There's different types of damage. Normally on a weapon, there's only attack damage. But now you're going to notice magic and void. And these actually add on to the normal damage. So on this one, it says 2 magic damage, 14 attack damage. This would actually be 16. You just add them together. It's pretty simple. If you go through here, there should be like one that's void as well. Yeah, we got void. So this one would be 20 damage. You can combine all those. There's all kinds of special effects on pretty much every weapon in the mod, which I thought was so cool. So this is what we're going to do. We can't test out every single one. So I got the best ones, and I put them in this chest for you. So first up, this lance right here has 4 magic damage plus 9 attack damage. That is the same as 13 attack damage. And it slows enemies and applies speed to you on hit. That's pretty cool. All right, so we're going to be running around. So one thing I did notice, a lot of these happen to look like zombies. So get ready for a goblin that looks exactly like a zombie. I don't know what. How do you look? You have weird eyes, little zombie. I know you're a zombie. Don't pretend you're some kind of goblin. So right now, guys, we do have a little bit of speed on us. The dude is slower. He's even smaller, maybe. And he's dead. He dropped some gold, which is kind of cool. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to try to go through every single mob in this mod. We'll try. There's really a lot in here. All right, so this one is the imp. Once again, it's a zombie. I don't understand it. Maybe someone should make more models for this mod. But look at the dude. We're going to take him out with this weapon. Don't you try to burn me. Oh, he gives the wither effect. That's dangerous. Run from the imp. We've got nausea, too. That's a really bad combination. Feeling a little bit woozy right now. So next up, we're grabbing the nether skull sword. This one has void damage. Plus, it withers the target and 10 attack damage. So once again, it's going to combine it and do extra damage. We'll get 13 plus. We will wither our enemies, and they'll be in pain. Let's go with the skeleton brawler. Let's get that terracotta. All right, here we go. Do you, if you're a zombie, I don't, do you even zombie, brah? I don't know. No, you skeleton. Good. All right, here we go. So this dude, getting some wither damage. He's got a sword in his hand. Oh, he hits like a beast. Just so you guys know, I let him hit me. I wanted to see how much damage it did, and it hurt me so badly. Taking him out this time. You try to do that again, bro? I don't think so. Don't think so. He drops leather. Well, he had leather armor on. It makes sense. The terracotta. If you're a zombie, I don't know what that is. It's a scarecrow. Steroids? Because you move? Is that a creeper, actually? It's got a weird model. Die! Oh, it hurts. Oh, my God. It's mind controlling me. All right, we got him. Wow. Don't mess with that, dude. He means serious business. Alright, so what I want to do, guys, is actually get some armor because these things are hurting me badly. So this is what we're going to do. Once again, everything has effects. I'm just going to pick the coolest looking one without actually looking. Let's go with this purple one. So this one, guys, fire resistance and resistance too. That should be pretty helpful. Let's toss it on. So yeah, a lot of armor. This is better than diamond. There's special extra armor bars as well. So this is a combination of everything. Just like the damage, it's a combination of armor bars. Alright, there we go. So I'm getting rid of these dudes because they freak me out. Don't even want to touch them. So next up, Stone Golem, Stone Bot, Thief, Shimmer Man. If it's a zombie, I'm going to cry. Oh, it's an Enderman. Is he holding a hoe? I gotta try this again. Is that a hoe? What are you holding, bro? What are you holding? I wanna know. Is it a quiver? You get back here. I know it's not nighttime. We'll get him after. Alright, the thief. Alright, we'll take out this dude. Doesn't even hurt, bro. He hit a lot harder than I expected. I almost cried. Alright, so this is a stone bot. It is a really injured, poor stone golem. You alright, bro? You alright? So I would imagine this dude actually would protect you, which is kind of cool. It's a work in progress, because it says, you know, whip next to his name. Hits pretty hard. But we took him out. Didn't drop stone, dropped iron. Alright, so this is the real stone golem. Smaller and evil. Come on, bro. I'm sorry I hit your father. Grandfather. He was kind of injured. Alright, we'll take him out. There we go. And that one actually dropped some stone. We are going to grab a new weapon, and this one looks freaking beautiful. Look at that. It's got a circle going around it. I don't know how practical that is, but it looks cool. So it's got magic damage, void damage, applies wither, plus 4 attack damage. It's called the Sword of Corruption. And you can see with the armor on, we have resistance 2 and fire resistance plus. We look ballin'. I'm just saying it. I can say ballin' and appreciate it. So we got some cool armor on. Let's actually fight a boss. I'm ready for this. So over here, guys, the ghost wither. That sounds like it's going to go really well. I feel like I need a stronger weapon. What else do we have in here? Some iron stars. Alright, so we got ninja stars. We'll throw those at the same time. We'll take out this ghost wither. I've never seen it. I actually haven't tested this because I wanted to see what would happen in the video and I'm going to die. It looks mad. Alright, ninja star, bro. What did you do to the ground? You broke out. Oh my god, that's pretty bad. I can't hurt you, can I? That's a lot of withers. They don't seem to want to go after me. I guess that's a good thing. That's a cool ability, though. It breaks the ground. They summon in withers that don't last forever. Come down here, bro. Let's do this. Let's dance. I really need a bow and arrow. I thought the ninja stars would work. If the Grim Reaper and the wither had a baby, this is what would happen. And apparently, it would ruin a lot of the terrain. So, I do have a bow. I can shoot it. 1 damage. That's really helpful. That's really good. So, guys, I'm just going to say it right now. This would be a very hard boss fight. Did you summon in this dude, too? It's going to take like 45 minutes. Run for your life. There is absolutely no way I can show every single boss in this. So, I'm going to go over the best stuff, guys. And feel free to download the mod and check it out for yourself. So, let's see what else we can get here. Tornado. Gotta know what that is. Blizzard. Let's fight it. Here we go. I'm really afraid to do it. I might wreck everything. But let's go for it. Tornado. It's a blaze. I actually want to try this. Irons. Ow, that is painful. Alright, so these do work on other mobs, not on that giant wither thing that is a beast. When you drop special blaze rod, got a storm rod. Cool, that is sick. We do have other weapons, guys. I've got this right here, the Void Lord Sword. Adds speed to and jump boost to, and it does void damage plus normal attack damage. Let's try it out on the blizzard. Should do the same thing, I imagine, plus like some kind of, yeah, blizzard effect. Pretty painful. Take out the dude. I know you're just a blaze. Don't you lie to me. So this is the giant Cyclops. I feel like I've seen this dude in about 50 different mods, but today, you die, bro. You die. What else do we have here? Look at this. Jumping like a beast. Void Fiend. Come on. That villager had a really bad day and became devil, I guess. I have no idea, but I'm going to kill it with fire. So guys, what I did is I grabbed all the coolest sounding mobs, and after this, we are going out to the bosses and the mini bosses. We've got 2 brand new weapons. This one slows enemies on hit. It's got magical damage. This one drains enemies on hit and pulls them in with void damage. I don't know if that's good if they're pulled in. Usually, I try to escape them, not make out with them, but I guess we're gonna try that out and see how it works. I'm gonna try that one first, actually. So let's go with this dude, Sapien Knight. Let's go, bro. Let's go. Suck into me. That sounds weird. I don't know if it's actually doing anything, but they are dying. I can't even feel this. What are you holding? What's that made of, plastic? Alright, dude is down. So this one is the Earth Mage. You holding a hoe? Oh god, we're getting owned by a hoe. This is embarrassing. I don't even think I can reach him. What are you, loving each other now? Going down. That's not a hoe. It's like a hammer. We're taking him out. One by one. Not too bad. Oh, we got the weapon? Oh, we did. The Sod Buster. That's cool. Hold on, let's try this out. So it says, what do we have to do? Punch left click for use. So if I use this. Oh my god, that is awesome. That is really cool. Alright, I'm going to actually try this on them. It seems much cooler when I get it. Let's go for it. Oh man, that is so cool. So if you get this weapon, you are going to destroy mobs. Guy died midair. like a little bit jealous because that's a cool death. It's cool to die sometimes as long as you're floating in the air. All right, so next up, who are we checking out? We have the Beefy Pig Man. This is my favorite name. I thought you'd be like really big or fat. Wait a second. That is really creepy. All right, so he is part wither skeleton, part pig man. They had a baby. This is what you would have. It's fine. We're going to try to fight this thing. Apparently, he doesn't want to fight us, so let's go for it. No knockback. He takes none. He's too beefy for that. Does not get knocked back. This one is the Nether Ghost. All right, come here. Let's try this other weapon. Where are you going, bro? You're going down. Don't fly from me. All right, I think we got him. I hope. I felt a heart. He liked it a little bit too much, which is probably a good sign, I guess. And over here, guys, we have the Fire Clops. This dude looks mad. He looks so grumpy. Look at that little face. Why are you not smiling? You don't smile? You don't smile, bro? Be happy. Take this. I love this weapon. I love it. It barely hurts him, huh? All right, we're going to die. You're going down, man. Going down. Took him out. We've got one more, guys. This one is some kind of Hannibal. Oh, he seems really upset. Is that like a smile? I hope not. Is that like your teeth? Please don't do that ever again. Please no. All right. Taking him out with the whole thing. Taking him out with it if we can. All right. We're just going to bust him down. Come on, bro. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go all day. All day. I'm going to die, aren't I? I got to say, some of these mobs have some cool abilities. They are no joke. So we do have a couple more weapons left over here. This one, it creates some kind of shield to protect you. That's going to be cool. Plus, it has void and magic damage. It is a beast of a weapon. We're going to need that against the mini bosses. So grab that. And this one, Vampiric, drains enemies on hit, hopefully to heal me nicely. So we'll grab that. And yeah, guys, you think that might be the end of the weapons. It's not even close. These are the magic ones. There's a lot. There's a lot of stuff. There's even books. Commands the power of gravity, but be careful. I'm going to grab this. Let's get... Shoots a shaft of energy. All right, let's go with that. And let's go on to some mini bosses and try this out. But first, I need new armor. We need something new. Let's go with the red one. Fire resistance, and strength too. So we're going to beast them down. So let's grab this set. Like seriously, there's like so many different kinds of sets with different abilities. All right, there we go. Let's put this on. Looking pretty awesome right now. Feels stronger than before. Got this giant weapon in my hands. Alright, so guys, over here are the mini bosses and the bosses. There is a ton. Let's pick out some cool ones and try them out. Alright, so let's see. Bandit Leader, Skeletal Mage, Spitting Troll. How do we not try that? I have no idea. Let's go with the Badgerer. Nether Badgerer. And finally, you're like the same thing. Let's go with the Bandit Leader. Alright, there we go. So we got three mini bosses to try out. We've got books. I don't know how that's going to work out for us. We're going to try it. So this one, it says be careful, so I'm nervous. Alright, gravity. Oh, do I fly? How does this flying work? What does this do? Oh! Alright, it works. When it says be careful, be careful. I didn't know I was flying into the air. My god, that is an epic noise. So we do have a couple cool weapons here, guys. We're gonna try them out on some of these mini bosses. This is the Spitting Troll. Spit at me. Was that spit? I think so, actually. Alright, we're gonna do this. Let's go, bro. Let's do this. Shoot it. Yes. He took some damage. Alright, let's try the weapons. Here we go. We got the strength too. It's taking them out so quick. He dropped some emeralds. He spit on me after he died. I saw it happen. What do we have over here? Metallic coins. It's got like a creeper face on it. Looks pretty cool actually. Look at that thing. That is awesome. Alright guys, so this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna fight another boss, the Nether Badgerer. I don't even know what that means, but it looks bad. Is he like really upset? Die. Please work. We might die here, guys. I think we do it. We do it. Oh, they are so tough. Some of these mobs are actually super tough to take out. You gotta do it quick if you want to survive. Oh, man. I had the derpiest face ever, too. Not to judge. My face looks similar, but I'm just saying. So, I'm just gonna toss on what I like to call an enchanted golden apple to save my life here. And by the way, guys, one thing you might have noticed during the review is on the bottom right, there is a magic bar. To use these magic abilities, like the stuff on these books, you need to charge that up. It goes back up over time. So, keep that in mind as you use them. Alright, so Bandit Leader, let's go. You look easy. Do you have a face? Do you have a face, bro? There we go. Oh, God! He seemed easy, but then he multiplied. Alright, we're taking him out. I think we got him. Ooh, that's a cool-looking weapon, actually. What is that thing? Alright, so this one, guys. The Whittler. It looks really strong. Let's check it out in my hand. Yeah, it looks really powerful. I've seen kitchen knives that looked better than this. All right, guys, I did a bunch of tests with this flying weapon. They kind of killed us before, and I noticed there's no way to survive it. When you use it, it just kind of, like, throws you into the air like a cannonball. So I'm going to try to use this again. I'm not even sure how it works, to be honest, because sometimes it seems to fly me into the air, but I'm going for it. Do this. All right, here we go. So you don't have control, then you die. All right, guys, so next up, what we're going to do is check out a bunch of the real bosses in this mod. I've got with me the Mega Stone Golem. I imagine it's going to be pretty big. It's going to be a big lady. It might be a woman. I don't know. We're going to find out in a second. We've got brand new weapons to test out. It doesn't say what they do, so we're just going to try it. I imagine the Wither Star Staff uses some kind of wither effect, but we will see in a second. So let's do it. How are you hurt already? I didn't even do anything. I didn't do it. You seem mad. I didn't do it. All right, so this thing is really upset. I'm going to take the weapon. We're going to try this. All right, so we're going to right click. And all kinds of effects are coming off me. Yes, I am the Wither. Feel my wrath, Stone Golem. So guys, it looks like with this in your hand, it actually just gives off the Wither effect to any mobs around you, which is an amazing effect, seriously. I'm not even doing anything, and the dude is dying. So that is pretty painful. Plus, with the right click, no, left click. I don't even know what happened there. With the left click, you shoot a skull at them, which does a ton of damage, and you are just like the Wither. But keep in mind, once again, you actually have to charge up the bar on the right, because right now, I can just stand here and at least use this. All right, guys, so weapon number two is the Hadrio Wand. So once again, it should have a couple cool abilities for us to use. Let's see what we can do here to this dude. Oh, man, that is going to be so cool. You know what? We need something out of the water. I can't fight him in there. We must fight him like a man. So I'm taking him out. Let's try this. All right, so left click. Bam! Yes, all right. This dude is insane. Oh my god, the derpy dude is here. All right, we're going to take him out. Why must I fly whenever I touch you? You're so weird. Don't jump on me. So one thing about the bosses in this mod is they have a ton of different abilities. You are going to want to be extremely careful or you're going to die. All right, guys, so next up we are checking out the Beholder, which is really big. Oh my god, that thing is hot. I'm just saying, you know, it's got fire. I meant it like that. So this is what we're going to do. We're going to try out a weapon, which is probably not going to work because I can't move. And let's do this. I think I shot a beam. I think so. I don't want to fight this right now. As you can tell, though, guys, there's some absolutely insane bosses in this mod. That thing is creepy. Wow. Yeah, I'm shooting some kind of beam at the dude. That's helpful. This is from the Chaotic Wand. Wait, we have an explosion wand. This might be our only chance to kill this ghast. It is clearly on steroids. Oh, did you see that? I mean, I missed the dude, but it looked amazing as it was going towards him. We need a boss we can actually see. And once again, guys, I do recommend trying the mod out if you want to actually fight that dude. This could be like a 7-hour video if I was fighting every boss to the end. So, we're going to try the Undead Warrior, which seems much more reasonable. It's like a really obese zombie, I guess. You got 80 health, not too bad. Other dude had like 500. Let's try this. Yes, explosion wand. So this actually explodes into your enemy, which is kind of cool. He summons in skeleton brawlers. What else do we have here? Meteor wand. Do it. Yes. Yes, I don't have any normal weapons on me, do I? Grab something. Grab it. Stab him. He has very high defense. It does one damage because of his armor. It's like he has 500. That's very bad for us. All right, here we go with the meteor wand. He's summoning in so many different mobs. My god, what are you, friends with everyone? You don't look like you would be. Just kidding. You look sexy. We do have one more weapon I really want to try out, and it says it actually controls earthquakes. Let's try it. I don't think I have enough magic. Ooh. Oh, look at that. Walk into it, bro. Let's try it again. That was really cool, actually. So it actually puts like an earthquake on the ground. Yeah, it holds them back. It does a lot of damage, too. It's great in a fight like this when you're fighting like tons of mobs at the same time. Very powerful stuff. We're going to try one more boss, and this one is called the Void Lord. Doesn't sound intimidating. Dude! Oh, it's like that other dude from before. But man, stop, I can't hear. It's bad things happening to us. Very bad. We are definitely going to die. I did want to mention that boss had a special ability that actually breaks your ears in real life. It was like if Slenderman had a baby with a really loud, obnoxious bird, that's what you would get. And apparently you'd be blind as well, so be careful of that. So we do have some tools over here, guys. I'm just going to grab a couple. We'll test them out. There isn't too much excitement with this. Like, what is this, though? That's a shovel? I want to try this one. That's a weird shovel. And that's apparently an axe. That's what my axe looks like at home. But, you know, it needs to be sharpened a little bit, but it's pretty good. It just takes, like, an hour to cut anything. So I'm gonna go over here. Oh, God, the dude is still... Oh, hi. Goodbye. Just gonna head over in this direction so we can chop down some stuff, guys. We do have a shovel. It's really quick, considering what it looks like. That is beastly. Wow. Oh, my God. That is amazing. So this axe, it can't be good. Do you see this thing? You see it? It goes nice with my set, though. All right. Kill it. Yes. This is actually really good stuff, guys. This is amazing tools in the mod. Much better than diamond. So we got one left. Let's go down and try it out. All right, so let's dump down here. I said dump down, but that's how I do. All right, we're dumping down here and beast moding through this. Extremely quick tools, very helpful. All right, guys, so we're back over here once again. Like I said, there's a lot of armor in this mod. This one, high enchantability, fire resistance, and haste. We got regrowth. I think that's like a healing move. We've got resistance too, fire resistance, invisibility, and speed. So basically, you can craft any of these and get some amazing buffs to help you out as you're fighting. So next up, there is a hoe in this mod. Appreciate it, guys. Normally, the mods forget this. This mod is a genius. Or mod creator, I should probably say. So this is the nether hoe. Hoes dirt like a boss. Hoes netherrack even better. I don't even know what that means. I haven't tried it, but I put down netherrack. We're gonna try it out. But first, let's hoe some stuff like a boss. Let's go for it. Right click. Oh, yes. Look at that. Best hoe I've ever seen in my life. So this is clearly a good mod, guys. Look at this. It just beast modes through everything. It even gets rid of the grass, which is a nice feature. Let's try it on netherrack. Oh, man. Look at that, guys. Oh, that is so sick. So it actually turns it all into soul sand as well. So, really cool. I'm really liking this. Best hole in the world. So, now it is time to dive into these dimensions. And I'm going to be honest, I did not look at them. I thought we'd all go together as a family. We'll go together. We'll enjoy this because I really don't know what to expect here, but let's do this. So, to make these guys, these are portal orbs. It's going to make a portal. All you have to do is craft them. It's pretty simple to get to the dimensions. This one is called the Sunset. It's going to be happy. Maybe, or it's gonna kill us. I don't really know. And this one, Crystallium, sounds a little bit more dangerous. Plus, guys, there's a work in progress one called the Dungeon Dimension. That could be amazing when it comes out. I'm excited for that. So, yeah, the area looks really good around here from everything it's been through today. But we are leaving. Let's go with the Sunset one first. I need something happy. Right click. Oh, this looks cool. Do something. Oh my God, is it building it? This is the most amazing thing I've ever seen in my life. Clearly, I need more life. Alright, come on, turn into a portal. I really don't know what to expect here, but this is much more amazing than I could have imagined. Alright, so do we jump into this? Ooh, we do. Wow, that was so much cooler. I'm glad that I actually showed that in the video and not like beforehand. So I imagine the other one probably like builds some kind of cool portal as well. How long this will take? No idea. I'm going to be honest, it took a couple minutes for this to load in, but we are in some kind of amazing village dimension. Look at this place. This is so sick. There's iron golems. We're actually up in the air too, guys. It's like a floating island. There's like pumpkins, all kinds of stuff, bridges. This actually looks like a really good mod. All right, so what's up, dudes? Check it out. Do you have... Oh, they're special villagers. These are sunset villagers. Got any weird traits? You come from another dimension. You look like you came from that dimension too, I'm just saying. All right, so in here, what do we have? We can steal some golden horse armor and stuff like that. This is so cool, guys. Look at this place. Oh, my God. This is an amazing village. What is this, dude? Magical villager. Bro, what do you sell? What do you sell? Rubies for a metallic coin. So it looks like they have their own currency here as well. I don't even know what he said. Oh, Ghibli Wobbit, my buns are burning. No comment. No comment, bro. Let's see what else you got in here. Let me in. How do you fit? What are you guys, skinnier than me? I'm too fat. No, I got in. Don't worry. So it looks like there's some kind of cool, like, lava area over here. There's, like, all kinds of attractions. This place is insane. Oh, my God. Look at that tree. I'm, like, I'm flabbergasted. Never said that word in my life. This is the first time I needed to say it. Look at this place. Wow. Now, that is an insane tree. I like this one even better than the one from Ore Spawn because it's, like, so decorated. Oh, my God. Let's go. Let's go. I might use this next season in the modded survival, guys. This is looking good. Don't fall off. It will hurt your buns. I don't know. That's what they say around here. So to get cooked troll meat. You eat trolls? You guys are violent people. Who are you? I'm Pat. George Tree. Hello, if you have time, could you find 3 magic gems for me? Ooh, so there's actually like quests and stuff around. I'm gonna see if I can find these. Oh man, that was rough. Found 3 right here. Alright, bro, I got them. There you go. Ooh, I got the elemental sword, guys. This is the thing we showed before. Totally worth it. I don't even know what I'm doing. What are you doing? Don't you try to moonwalk. You can't do it. You have no skills. So this is a really nice looking dimension. Wow, this is beautiful. Let's go to the top. Is there a kit? Oh, is that a nether portal? Got a nether portal right there? Oh, that's pretty cool. So this dimension is fantastic. I have no other way to describe this. This is an absolutely awesome dimension. There's an enchantment table over there. This might be the coolest house I've ever seen in my life. I would steal this. I'd have to slaughter them all, of course, but it would totally be worth it. All right, let's see. So we do have another one. This is probably gonna be horrible in comparison, but let's go for it. Build me an epic portal. Please, I am expecting good things from you. All right, here we go again. It's probably gonna be like the other one. Build the little, you know, thing up top that looks funny. Go for it, come on. I'm impatient. All right, this one's gonna look a little bit different. I can't believe this. This is so sick. So it sounds like they're gonna add in some kind of dungeon dimension as well. I can't wait to check that out. And here we go, light it up. Come on, bad boy. I don't think I should say that ever. Let's go. All right, guys, we have made it, and it's a little bit disappointing in comparison to the last one. It really looks like a work in progress. I see absolutely nothing. It's a flat land. I can't believe the difference here. So at the moment, this is nothing, guys. There's nothing here. It's just a giant land. I don't know if there's like, maybe, you know what? Maybe there's an underground section we don't know about. Let's dig for it. Let's go for it. Oh, there is. Oh, I found it. Oh my god, I was right. All right, thank god for that. We spawned on top. Apparently, this is really creepy looking. What is this thing? It's like a giant spike coming down from the sky. So this is actually kind of like the Eternal Frost dimension. I don't know if you guys have seen that mod or not, but instead of having like a world above, there is a giant world underneath the ground. And what is that? Is that a castle? I must see it now. There's a lot of creepy mobs spawning here. Creepy stuff everywhere. But we must go to this castle. Are those spawners? Oh, this looks dangerous. This looks like a tough place. Tons of spawners. But is there some kind of massive reward? We must find out right now. What is this? Is this a reward? Or is it a spawner? It looks like a spawner, actually. But yeah, guys, look at this place. Absolutely insane. Once again, the top of the world. If you spawn there, remember, dig down. There is clearly structures, spawners, mobs, all kinds of stuff around. Definitely a lot of dangers to check out. I don't even know what I'm saying. Definitely a lot of dangers down here. And weird rat people or something in front of us. Next up, we are checking out some of the overworld structures. I've noticed there's actually quite a few, so if you're going around your normal world, it is kind of like better dungeons. So this one is pretty normal, not too much to show. Bunch of these skeleton brawler dudes around here. So basically, you need to make it to the bottom, to the boss. It's what we're doing. Hopefully we'll get there soon. Did I go too far? Wait. Wait a second. Alright, so we go over here, guys, and check this out. And there is the boss we fought before. That is the undead warlord. So if you can get down here, there is plenty of bosses and mobs to fight. The next one right here is not a dungeon, but actually just a cool structure that spawns in your world. So if you go over here, there's a cool like little water fountain. Skeleton faces, apparently many have died here. Many have died. Not making out with you. So let's see, is there anything under this? It looks kind of weird, doesn't it? I don't think there is. Just happens to look like this, spawn like this on some water. Actually, did it spawn on water? It looks like it actually may have. So right here, guys, we just have a little structure, not too much to show, but apparently much has died here. There's a tree in it. Tree happened to spawn inside it. We are on to some of the cooler looking ones. This is a really interesting looking village. It's got like a lot of steps up to the houses. I don't know, maybe it floods here. Maybe they're paranoid. So cool looking place. Lots of villagers around. I like the style. Definitely haven't seen one like this in a mod before. The villagers are normal. Normal trades, nothing special here, just a bunch of houses to explore, a bunch of villagers to see. Wait a second. Magical villager, come here. So, ooh, you can actually get one of the sets, guys. This is the bedrock set, which gives you resistance to and fire resistance. So you can trade for some of this stuff with a bunch of those coins from before. Yeah, lots of stuff, guys. Oh, this is the weapon that dropped before. It looks so powerful. So tiny, though. Wait, we must see everything. Everything. So you can get magical gems from this dude, a bedrock sword, all different kinds of stuff. So definitely check the trades. So this is what we're gonna do. We're gonna go over to this structure. There's like so many around. There's structures absolutely everywhere in your world. There's even another one over there, guys. So I believe this is just like the other structure we saw before, except there's different mobs and a different boss at the bottom. Like, I didn't see him before. Nice hole you got going, bro. Props to you. So I don't think I'm going to go down to the bottom because it's pretty much exactly the same as the other one, just different mobs. But look at this beast. It's got a flag on it. It is a giant castle. It looks amazing. And I believe there's some houses and stuff in the middle. Check it out real quick. So over here, guys, we got some spawners. It looks really cool. There's all kinds of wool and stuff inside. It's decorated quite nicely. And yeah, another giant structure to check out. This is the last one I was able to find that wasn't like exactly the same as another one. Like, there's a bunch of dungeons that are like different kinds of blocks and different mobs, very similar. So this is a treehouse. You're probably gonna find this on your first day in Minecraft. It's a little bit dangerous. It's got these dudes. Look like the white knights from RuneScape. So in here, guys, there is a chest. You can get some stuff. Copper ingots. Make yourself some kind of tool. Ain't it good? How good is this stuff? Do you have a sword? 6 attack damage. Not bad, but it doesn't last very long, apparently. So kind of cool if you find something like this. Like, run in, steal this stuff, jump out. If you go through a forest, there should be a ton of these spawning. Anyways, guys, that is about all there is to show with this mod. It adds in tons of content, structures, mobs, bosses, anything you could think of. It looks really good, too. I'm super excited for this one. I can't wait to try it out myself in survival. But yeah, guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, definitely crush that like button like a beast and subscribe as well. That would mean so much to me. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Peace out.